Ciao Nick, I'm making tiramisu today, but not the normal one, not the traditional one. I'm making strawberry tiramisu. And this is because to make classic tiramisu, you need very, very fresh eggs. And I'm not really sure where to find them here in Bristol, so I've opted for another version of the tiramisu for which you don't need eggs. So I've never made strawberry tiramisu before, so this is the first time for me, even if I had eaten it so many times and it's absolutely delicious. The recipe is from the website of my mate Chiara Passion, so this is another one of her delicious recipes that it will be a success for sure, but let's try and do it together because I've never done it before. So the ingredients for this recipe are 12 sponge fingers, even if I have some comments on this, 500 grams of strawberries, 2 tablespoons of sugar, the juice of 1 lemon, 500 grams of mascarpone, 250 grams of double cream, and 170 grams of evaporated milk. The comment I have on the sponge fingers, which in Italian are called savoiardi, is that I found some from Asda. So these are this is the pack of the sponge fingers that I found in Asda, but they are very small compared to the Italian ones. So when I did tiramisu a few months ago, I bought savoiardi from an Italian deli here, and those were the normal ones, the Italian ones, the normal sized ones. These sponge fingers from Asda are really small compared to this, and basically I think that you could say that the thickness of a normal savoiardo would be twice the thickness of this sponge finger. So the only attention we need to make is not to make them too soggy. So I've done some prep last night, just because you need to prep the strawberries, and the more you leave them in the fridge, well, not for days, but like at least, the recipe says at least 1 hour, but I've left them overnight. The juicier they become. So what I've done is to cut them in little pieces, and then I put them in a bowl. I've used the 2 tablespoon of sugar, the juice of 1 lemon, and if you want you could add a shot of rum as well, or a shot of limoncello, but I didn't because I know you don't drink a lot anyway. And then I mixed it and I put it in the fridge, and I've just taken it out now. The first thing we have to do, well, not the first, but we can do it now, is to filter the juice, because that's what we will be using for to wet the fingers. So I'll get a sieve and I'll filter it in this bowl. Okay, sieve, ding 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 ding. Okay, and let's hope it works. So I don't know if you can see all the liquid. All the liquid coming out. Let's try it. Oh my god. Delicious. Okay. So I'll put it on the side and I'll leave it to drain. In the meantime, what I have to do is to prep the cream. And I'll do so by first whipping the double cream. And the mascarpone, I forgot the mascarpone. Mascarpone, I forgot to take it out. How can you make tiramisu without mascarpone? I want to say something about mascarpone. We use mascarpone only for tiramisu in Italy. I seriously can't think about another recipe with mascarpone. We use it for maybe other puddings, but I mean, in England you use mascarpone much more than we do in Italy. So yeah, it's a bit of a, it's a mystery. I don't know. It's quite curious, I think, that, you know, it's you use it, you know, for silky pasta sauces and indulgent desserts. We never put mascarpone in pasta sauce, so it's quite interesting. The recipe says 250 grams of double cream. This is 300 milliliters. Oh God, what's the difference? I'll have to wait. I'll have to measure it with a scale. Okay, so let's see. Yeah, okay, so basically this is 250 grams, so I'll pour it all because I'm not throwing anything. So cream is whipped. Okay, I'll put it in the fridge. While that is in the fridge, I'll have to whip the mascarpone and the condensed milk. Okay, so very tidy today. Now that. I'm so clumsy. Robert, I'll wash my hands a second. I have to open the evaporated milk tin. I don't even know if it's solid, if it's liquid. Oh. But, okay, let's open it. It's liquid. So much so that the lid, Maxolino was sleeping. Let's see if he likes the milk. Maxolino, do you like the milk? Look. Do you like this, Maxolino? He likes it. So Maxolino approved the condensed milk. Basically, I have to whip the mascarpone while I gently pour the condensed milk in. So let's try this. Oh God. Bless you. Just me, Max. Let's do the test of the teaspoon. So if you grab a teaspoon and it comes down, it stays on quite a bit. Can you see it? So we get a teaspoon of the mix. Can you see that it still stays on? I think it's ready because we have to put the whipped cream as well. Now we take the whipped cream out of the fridge, we put it in it and we mix it doing movements from the bottom to the top with the spatula. Those movements from the bottom to the top. And in theory, that should allow the air in the whipped cream not to break. So it should give more volume to the mix. Okay, let's try the teaspoon again. Ta-da! Fantastic, eh? Look. I I like to use see-through containers. You can use, you know, lunch boxes, or this is an ex. This was an ice cream tray. And it's nice to use see-through containers, so you can see the layers, you can see the sponge fingers. But I like to make mini portions. I use jars. This was a jar of olives, for example, with a lid, and you can store them in the fridge, and so you have the portions already ready. Or if you have guests, I use glasses. So you can use water glasses like this, or if you want to be fancier, you can use a martini glass, or I have this wine glass from IKEA that I personally love. So I'll try and do different combinations now, see what comes out and how they look. Okay, so tiny bit of cream at the bottom, one and two. You spread it a bit, so when you put the first sponge fingers, they don't move. And then, let's see, just the top, and then I'll break it to fit the glass. Actually, I can put another one, top and top. Delicious. Have I done it wrong? Strawberries, cream. Oh no, bye-bye. And strawberries, okay. Well, it doesn't really matter, does it, in the end? And then another layer of cream. This, I think this is enough. Can you see the layers? Once you can put just a little bit of mint like this for decoration. It smells really nice. Amore, do you want some tiramisu? No, okay. Nick, long story short, I've done a lot of tiramisu. I've done these little jars. I've done the glasses, which we've already eaten. And I've done two boxes, which I'll give to my neighbors, I think. Because who is gonna eat all this tiramisu? I don't know. This said, I want to say that I've used much more than 12 sponge fingers, especially the small ones, so I've used a full pack of sponge fingers. I'm gonna just say ciao, and I hope you enjoyed, and let me know if you like this. I will make you the normal one, but let me know if you know where I can find really fresh eggs. Ciao, ciao.